Today, I'm going to show you how to use ChatGPT in Google Sheets without having to write code or use AppScript. And if you stick around to the end, I'm going to show you one other way to use AI in spreadsheets that makes things even easier. First, let's jump in. Let's say I have a contact list in Google Sheets, and I want to add an email where AI is going to draft up a quick email asking if this person would like to schedule a call and make it personalized to that person. First thing I do is just add a column called email, and then I click extensions, go into AppScript, and write a whole bunch of code. Just kidding, we're not gonna do that. Instead, we're gonna use Zapier, the no-code way to do it. In Zapier, you can connect Google Sheets with ChatGPT. All you need to do is set up a very simple Zap. It triggers when a new spreadsheet row comes into the Google Sheet. You have ChatGPT write you an email, and then you update that spreadsheet row. So every time a new spreadsheet row comes in, it'll have an email. When you add ChatGPT into Zapier, you connect your OpenAI account and choose write an email. It gives you fields to map in the recipient's name, their email, the from name, and then the simple prompt. Here, I'm gonna ask if they'd like to schedule a call. Reference their title and their company name. You give it a tone, choose your model, and then once that spits out an email, you have it update that spreadsheet row with the outputted email. So what does this look like in Google Sheets? Well, you've got that filled out here in its own cell. Not bad. So now when I add new contacts into the sheet, the Zap will run, send it to ChatGPT, and then the emails appear. Amazing. Now that certainly can work well with Google Sheets. You can use the ChatGPT step to put in any prompt and do whatever you want it to do. But there's one more way I want to show you that allows you to add an AI field even more easily. That product is called Tables. It's built by Zapier for automation and for AI. So not only can you add in records with AI fields, which I'll show you in a second, you can create buttons that kick off automations that will actually send that email instead of just drafting it up in Google Sheets. So when you're in Tables, you can import the data from the CSV that you export from Google Sheets. Just click CSV and pull in the file. All the fields show up and are mapped. Once it creates the table, then we can add that AI field in. Let me show you how easy this is. You click add field, click AI field, call it email, and you don't even need an OpenAI authentication. Zapier gives you their own to use. You can use yours if you want, but using theirs out of the box makes it super easy. You click create a prompt, you can start from scratch or start from one of the templates they have. We'll choose start from scratch, write an email to, and then you choose the fields from the table, reference their title and company name, and sign off as Bryce. You can test it to see what it puts out. If that looks good, you click done, click create, and then that automatically updates for every single contact in the table. You can add more AI fields if you want, or even add a button to send the email that kicks off an automation to do that. You would just click to set up the button, set up the automation to send an email in Gmail or whatever email client you have. If you do plan on automating a bunch of steps or actually sending emails and doing other actions, Zapier Tables might be the best bet. But if you're just wanting to quickly manipulate data in a Google Sheet, then that works for you. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel, especially if you want to learn more about how to add AI into your workflows.